So anyway, I'll just announce the shortlist of people who've been selected for the main quiz. So first I'll announce the school students. So the first team is, this is not in any particular order, just the five highest scores. So the first team is Simon, Elias, and Mohan B., Don Bosco Egmore, and Rishi Valley School. You can pick any of these chairs, yeah. Then we have P. Adha Venkatesh and Koshi Elias. One person is from KPC VSS Arundakam, and the other person is from Don Bosco Egmore. Are they here? The third school team is Shweta Srinivasan and P. Sharon, Sacred Heart, Church Park. Are they here? Okay, the next team is Vaidheeshwaran Ramesh and Nitish Kumar, DAV Boys Senior Secondary School and Infant Jesus. So I'm a little confused about this one. Is Vignesh Balaji here? Vignesh Balaji? Not here? Okay, because this was just a single person attempted this and he hasn't written any school or college name, so I'm not even sure if this is a school student or a college student. So I'm skipping this one. Since the person is anyone not here. So the next team is R. Gautam and S. V. Jayavatsan, PS Metric Higher Secondary School. Your partner is missing, is it? Who was it? Simon. What happened to him? He's not with you, okay. So I there's actually one more, wait. Who's partner, your partner, right? How many teams do we have? We have one team, your partner too? Okay, this is tricky. So why don't you guys form one team, right? I mean, the next team I'll just anyway announcing. So you guys, are you okay with being in the same team? Because I have another two people, so I can't, so I don't know. Are those two guys okay with splitting? Actually, it won't make sense, so why don't you guys just join together? It's okay, right? Okay, so that's okay. Yeah. So the next, so I announced the name, right? I mean, what was, okay, all the partners are here. Now I've mixed up the college teams. College students. Let me just go through that. Okay. So now the college students. So there are five college students that we have selected, and you can pick and choose which team you want to go for. Actually, it's if you have a particular preference, I'll just announce the names. Just join any of the teams. Okay. They get? Ah, okay. So you guys can bid. Okay. So, should I announce the name, all the names? Okay. So the names I announced, please walk forward. Like, just make yourself visible. So Jayadev Vijayan from Loyola College. Here. Where's Jayadev? Okay. He's upstairs. Please come downstairs. What is it? Okay. Then we have Mukesh S. from SSN College of Engineering. Is he here? Mukesh? Yeah. Then we have Mukesh K. from College of Engineering, Guindy. Okay. So Mukesh K. Then S. Arvind Kumar from Jaipur Mamaman Institute of Technology. And then we have, how many do we have so far? We have 1, 4, 4. Okay. So the next person is Raja from IIT Madras. Is he here? Yeah, hi. So we have five. So you guys pick one person. Those four or this person? You can make yourself visible there. Or, yeah, okay, just. Yeah, you guys, your call. Anyone? Okay, fine. You guys, any? Okay, yeah, go ahead. You. Okay, you guys already decided or what? Okay, the last person. Yeah. Thank you. So we have five teams here. Bhabha, Bose, Chandra, Raman, and Saha. Okay. So can we have the slides? Yeah. So we'll just start with the first round. By the way, I'm Ravi. So this is my second time doing this quiz. So the first round is a general round. We'll have 10 questions. There'll be two direct questions to each team. In case there's any doubt, please ask before the round starts. So there are 10 questions during the round, 2 straight questions to each team. We'll go in a particular order. A direct question earns you 20 points. You get 30 seconds to answer it. A pass question will earn you 10 points, and there's no extra time for it. Okay? We'll just pass it on in sequence. So any questions? I'll be anyway reading out the question. I hope you guys can look at the screen, right? You can more or less read it, right? Can you guys, you can move a little forward if you wish. No, you guys. At least one member from each team should be able to look at the screen. It's okay, actually you don't need the screen. I'll be reading it out anyway, but in case you want to look at it, you can look at it. The thing is that the stage is kind of small, and I had trouble arranging 15 chairs in 5 teams appropriately. So anyway. So are the rules clear? Any questions? Okay, then we can go ahead. So we'll start clockwise, and so we'll go this way this round, and in the next round we'll go in the opposite direction. So let's begin. So the first question will go to Bhabha. So here's your first question. Who said it was almost as if you fired a 15-inch shell into a piece of tissue paper, and it came back and hit you? And what was he talking about?
Ernst Rutherford, about his gold foil experiment.
Correct. The scorers? Yeah. So it's Ernest Rutherford about the gold foil experiment. Fact, this is just trivia. He famously said that all science is either physics or stamp collecting, which means he probably felt very terrible when he won the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1908. That's courtesy of Madhusudan. So next question. This is for Team Bose. Who coined the phrase survival of the fittest? You have 30 seconds.
Charles Darwin.
Sorry, it's not Charles, pass. Pass. You guys want to try? No? Okay. Audience, anybody?
Darwin's incorrect.
Darwin's bulldog.
No, it's not even Darwin's bulldog. Not even Wallace. Herbert Spencer, yes.
Should I give you a chocolate? I don't need to give you a chocolate. Other members in the audience will get a chocolate. But anyway, I'll give you one. So you get a chocolate if you get a question right. So we have had 2 questions so far. Herbert Spencer, a British polymath. In his lifetime, Spencer made contributions to fields as diverse as evolution, sociology, ethics, political theory, economics, and religion. Fact, He also invented a precursor to the paperclip, which goes to show that a proficient theorist can at times do things of practical value. I haven't done anything so far, not even a paperclip. But anyway, next question. This is for Team Chandra. In a letter in 1676, Sir Isaac Newton wrote, "What Descartes did was a good step. You've added much several ways, and especially in taking the colors of thin plates into philosophical consideration. If I have seen a little further, it is by standing on the shoulders of giants." Who was this letter addressed to? Team Chandra. 30 seconds.
Galileo Galilei.
Sorry, no. They were not contemporaries. So it couldn't be addressed to Galileo. And I think Galileo passed away in 1642 or something. So pass. Yeah. Huh? No. No? No,
not Google. Huh? No idea. Audience?
Robert Hooke is correct. You can come down and take your chocolate, or I can try to throw it, but I mean, anyway. So it's Robert Hooke. He's the Hooke's Law guy, and the school students might know Hooke's Law, right? I mean, the spring force, right? I mean, spring force being proportional to negative of the. Anyway, it's not him. Anyway, the next question is for Team Raman. So what is the Hardy-Ramanujan number, and what is unique about it? 30 seconds. No, it's not his date of birth. Hardy-Ramanujan number, what is unique about it? It's not 1739. You have 30 seconds. Sorry, you've had your attempt, I'm sorry. Next. Huh? No, it's not 13. Okay, so they get 10 points for this question. Scorers, yeah. So Hardy-Ramanujan number is 1729. It can be expressed as a sum of cubes of 12 and 1 and 10 and 9. This was a fact pointed out by Ramanujan when he was quite sick and Hardy was visiting him, and I believe it was the taxi number, and he said that it's a very boring number, and Ramanujan pointed out that it's an interesting number for this reason. Audience. Next question is for Team Saha. So your question is this. The 17th century mathematician and philosopher invented calculus, upset Isaac Newton, propounded rationalism, built a series of ingenious mechanical calculators, and is noted in philosophical circles for his shameless optimism. Who are we talking about? Huh? Charles? No.
Leibniz.
Leibniz. Yeah, 10 points to Baba. So this is Leibniz. Okay, so we're through with the first half of this round, 5 questions so far. And the scores are? Anyway, okay, so Team Bhabha has 40 points. The other teams are yet to score. Okay, so now we'll go to the second half of this round. So since you guys already are leading, let's start with them. Yeah, okay. So Team Saha, the next question is for Team Saha. So she was Lord Byron's only legitimate daughter, commonly considered the world's first computer programmer. She assisted Charles Babbage in his work on the analytical engine, and he referred to her as the enchantress of numbers. Who is she? Time up. You want to give it a shot? Chandra?
Sada Lovelace.
Huh?
Huh? Ada Lovelace.
Ada Lovelace, 10 points to Chandra. The next question is for Team Raman. What is the common name of Lepidochelys oliversia? I'll give you a clue. I mean, think of a color. Anyway, yeah. Audience, please don't prompt.
The name of a butterfly?
No. Next team? Chandra? No. Bose?
It's a butterfly.
It's not a butterfly. It's not a flower. Huh? Olive what? Olive is a... No, not olive oil. No, close. Audience.
Not yellow, huh? Olive Ridley, yes.
It's the Olive Ridley turtle. A fact about Olive Ridleys, they nest along the Chennai coast between... chocolate. They nest along the Chennai coast between late December and mid-April. They're still nesting along the... So sometimes you'll still see some Olive Ridleys along the Elliott's Beach area. They usually nest through the night, so you won't see it during the day.
So it should be said that the guest butterfly wasn't a bad one, because does anyone know what the term for someone who collects butterflies is? Yeah, lepidopterist, right? I think two teams tried butterfly, so they're called lepidopterists, but I don't know what the connection is with the turtles. That would be an interesting thing to look up maybe when you get back home. So, yeah.
Thanks, Madhu. So the last question was for Ramana. The next question is for Chandra. Name the man with the most famous marginal contribution to mathematics. You must have heard of him. 30 seconds. Think marginal, yeah. A clue, anyway. Yeah.
Descartes.
No, it's not Descartes.
Fermat.
Fermat, yeah. So, 10 points to Bose. So it's Fermat's last theorem. Then the next question is for Team Bose, I believe, right? Yeah. So Team Bose, the next question. He invented the mirror box to alleviate phantom limb pain. Also, Richard Dawkins called him the Marco Polo of neuroscience. Who are we talking about? He has a Chennai connection. Just a clue.
Michael Shermer?
No, it's not Michael Shermer. Next team? Baba? No? Saha? Huh? Not Robert Bowen. Raman? Chandra?
Nicholson.
Michael?
Son.
No. Audience, sorry. Yeah, audience. Anybody in the audience? You tried once. V.S. Ramachandran, yes. That's chocolate. Please come and collect. Okay, wait. I'll try. No? Okay, that went. Okay, that was good. Yeah. I mean, the catch. The next question is for Team Bhava. The Chemical History of a Candle was the title of a series of 6 lectures on the chemistry and physics of flames, which were later published as a book in 1861. Who gave these lectures?
Michael Faraday.
Michael Faraday, yes, that's correct. 20 points to Team Bhabha. So we're at the end of the first round. The scores are Team Bhabha is leading with 60 points. Then Team Bose, 10 points. Team Chandra, 10 points. And the other two teams, Raman and Saha, are yet to open. Then, okay, so this was the first round. We have another round. The second round is an identification round. It's a visual round. Can we have the rules for the round? I'll just announce the rules. In case of any doubt, please ask. Okay, so there'll be two direct questions again to each team. There'll be three clues per question. You'll get 15 seconds for each clue. And plus 20 if you get it with zero clues, 15 if you get it with one clue, 10 if you get it with two clues, and 5 points if you get it with three clues. Are the rules clear? 15 seconds per clue. You have the option of without answering it without any clues. Then you get 20, then 15, 10, and 5. So are the rules clear? Any questions? No, it won't pass. And you can actually come here and look at the picture. It's not an issue. Huh? You guys can see it. Huh? So if you can't see it, please come here and look at it. Okay, so we'll start. So how did we start? So maybe we'll go this way and then this way. Is that fine? Because last time we went this way and this way. So I think, yeah. So okay, we'll start with Team Saha. So the first question is for Team Saha. Identify her. Can you identify her? Do you want a clue? Okay, the first clue. She's a British primatologist. No? Okay, next clue. Next clue. She's best known for her 45-year study of social and family interactions of wild chimpanzees in Gombe Stream National Park, Tanzania. Can you? We have 15 seconds. Okay, next clue. She's considered to be the world's foremost expert on chimpanzees. No? Audience, anybody in the audience? The questions are not passing, so you're kind of part of the audience. If you want to try, let me know. Jane Goodall, yeah, I mean, but I wanted to let the audience try. Anyway, you guys are not allowed to be part of the audience. Yeah, so she's Jane Goodall. The next question is for Team Raman. Okay, so can you identify him? First clue? He's a British physicist at the University of Oxford. No, he's not Richard Feynman. He's not never at Oxford. Second clue. He proposed the quantum Turing machine in 1985 and pioneered the field of quantum computation. No? Third clue. He, along with a collaborator, proposed the Deutsch-Jauze algorithm in 1992. This almost gives it away, so you should try. I mean, like, it's been a long time. But Jane Goodall, they knew. Audience, does the audience want to try? Anybody? No? You guys want to try? Huh? No. No, no. Any guesses? No? Anybody in the audience? Huh? Look, the third clue almost gives it away. It's either Deutsch or Joser. It's David Deutsch. I'm telling you, I told you, it almost gave it away. It's Deutsch Joser algorithm. Anyway, so this was Team Raman, right? So the third question is for Team Chandra. Can you identify him? No prompting from the audience. We have 15 seconds. First clue. He is an Indian physicist at the University of Texas at Austin. Second clue. He is well known for his contribution to quantum optics and the V minus A theory of the weak force. Third clue. He's a former director of IMSC Chennai. He's a former director of this place. That's why you should know institutes in your city, you know. No? Pass. Any of the other teams? You guys want to try? No? Audience. Wait, I mean, I get to choose who to ask. Wait. That girl, yeah. No, it's not Aladi Ramakrishnan. No. You, yes. Huh? Yes, Sudarshan.
Sorry.
Okay, so that's E.C. George Sudarshan. So this is Chandra. The next question is for Team Bose. Can you identify him? First clue? Okay, so he was a preeminent Soviet mathematician in the 20th century. He's a Soviet mathematician. A preeminent mathematician. Second clue? In 1933, he published his book, Foundations of the Theory of Probability, laying the modern axiomatic foundations of probability theory. The college guy should know, I mean, right? Third clue, in his study of stochastic processes, he developed the Chapman-Kolmogorov equations.
Kolmogorov?
Huh?
Kolmogorov.
Kolmogorov, 5 points to Bose. Look, I mean, the team should pay attention. The third clue almost gives it away, so you should be attentive, you know. Watch out for the third clue. So, yeah, so that's Kolmogorov. The last question of this part of the round is for Team Bhabha. So, can you identify him? No? First clue? This child grew up to become a highly influential British mathematician, logician, cryptanalyst, and computer scientist. Next clue. During the Second World War, he was involved in breaking the German Enigma ciphers at Bletchley Park.
John Nash?
It's not John Nash, sorry. Oh, you want the third clue? Of course, yeah. Okay, third clue. In June 2012, we celebrated his birth centenary. He was in the news. He's been in the news for a while now. Anyway. Huh? No, it's not Andrew Wiles. Wait. Not you guys, audience. Audience, let me decide who to ask. This is one of the few times I get to choose. Not Charles Babbage. Okay, Alan Turing, yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, well, good. Okay, so we are through with the first five questions of this round, and the scores are Team Bhabha has 60 points, Team Bose, 15 points. Chandra has 10 points. And Raman and Saha are yet to open their account. OK. So we're through with the first half of this round. The second half will go this way. So the next question is for Team Baba. Identify him. First clue. He is often called the father of the atomic bomb for his role in the Manhattan Project. No prompting from the audience, please. Next clue. On the detonation of the first atomic bomb in New Mexico, 1945, he later remarked that it brought to mind words from the Bhagavad Gita, "Now I am become death, the destroyer of worlds." 15 seconds on this clue.
Homi Baba?
No, it's not Homi Baba, come on. Next clue. He is well known for the Born-Oppenheimer approximation for molecular wave function. No prompting.
Oppenheimer,
yes. Watch out for the third clue. Anyway, so this is Oppenheimer. The second question is for Team Bose. Identify him. Shh. No prompting. First clue? First clue. In 2005, he founded the Agumbe Rainforest Research Station. This is in Karnataka. Second clue. An Indian herpetologist and wildlife conservationist, he founded the Madras Croc Bank in 1976. Look, I'm assuming you guys are from Chennai. He founded the Croc Bank. Next clue. He's often called the Snake Man of India. Audience. We'll get it. Time up. Yeah, but I don't know if the audience heard that. What's the answer? Yeah, that's Romulus Whitaker. Look, people in Chennai should know him. Anyway, so the next question is.
I'm sorry. Somebody got it.
Okay, so the next question is for. This is Chandra, right? Okay, the next question is for Team Chandra. Identify him. A first clue. He was a British doctor who received the Nobel Prize for Physiology or Medicine in 1902 for his work on malaria. Second clue. He commenced the study of malaria in 1892. He discovered that malaria was transmitted by Anopheles mosquito.
Ronald Rose.
Do it. It's whose question?
Ronald Rose.
You gave it away. What are you doing? Anyway, so that's their mistake. No? So that's Ronald Ross. The third clue, we can have the third clue. He was born in Almora, India, and he studied medicine in London in 1875, joined the Indian Medical Service in 1881. His first posting was in Madras. That's how many? 10 points. 10 points for these guys. The next question is for Team Raman. This is your question, so you should answer it. Identify him. First clue. He was an Indian physicist, the first recipient of the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize for Science and Technology in 1958. Also a Padma Bhushan and a fellow of the Royal Society. Yeah, go ahead. No? Next clue. We'll give you another clue. He attended American College Madurai and Madras Christian College Chennai. Not sure that helps, but yeah. We have 15 seconds. Is it up? Okay, next clue. In 1920, he went to work with C.V. Raman at ISES Calcutta. He was co-discoverer of Raman scattering, for which his mentor C.V. Raman was awarded the Nobel Prize in 1930, the Physics Nobel 1930. Third clue. 15 seconds. You want to help them? A time up. Okay. So, audience. Okay. Yeah. Huh? Who? K.S. Krishnan. Yeah, that's K.S. Krishnan. Okay. The next question, this is the last question of this round. It's for Team Saha. Can we have the next question? Identify him. Clue, first clue. This Hungarian-born American polymath has contributed prolifically to all the three streams studied at Math Science, mathematics, physics, and computer science. Next clue. His work on operator theory clarified the mathematical formulation of quantum mechanics. That's not Niels Bohr. Third clue. He founded the field of game theory as a mathematical discipline. Time up. Audience. Dude, no. I'll ask. Wait, let me choose. Anybody? You're from Math Science. No, not you. You've answered before. Yeah, you. No, that's not Niels Bohr. Come on. Yeah? Yeah, that's von Neumann. Yeah. So that's John von Neumann. So he founded, anyway, yeah, so a lot of things. So we have, at the end of two rounds, the scores are Team Bhabha, 65 points, Bose, 15 points, Chandra, 20 points, Raman and Saha are yet to open their accounts. Okay, so at the end of, yeah? Oh, there's a bonus question. This is like free for all. I mean, anybody can attempt it. I tried this last time as well. I like this question a lot. So anyway, yeah, so identify her. Anybody? I choose. You just raise your hand if you're interested in answering. Not you. In 1942, along with composer George Antheil, she patented what they call the secret communication system, intended to solve the problem of enemies blocking signals from radio-controlled torpedoes during World War II. People who were here for the last quiz would, I mean, a couple of years back we had a quiz where I had asked the same question. Okay, the next clue. Her brilliant idea was to use frequency hopping. That was her invention. This idea is used in wireless communication. Yeah.
You are. Morse.
Huh? Hmm. Who? Anybody? No? Okay, the last clue. She was also a Hollywood actress.
Vivian.
It's not Marilyn Monroe. How can you miss it?
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Is it Vivian Leigh?
No, it's not her. It's not Audrey Hepburn. Would it be nice if it was her? No.
Vivian
Leigh. Anybody? Where's Sondheb? He was raising his hand a while back. Yeah, you can answer it now. No? Oh, you want to try?
Is it Vivian Leigh?
That's not Vivian Leigh. Yeah, so that's, you won't get a chocolate because you know the answer. I mean, I know you know the answer. So. That's Hedy Lamarr. And yeah, so she's one of those rare instances of somebody in Hollywood having a patent. Anyway, so this is like, this is the end of the second round. The next round is where the teams can do some catching up. Because it's a buzzer round, and let's just check your buzzers first. So there's a switch there. I'll wait. Yeah. Okay. So you pressed it. Why don't you press yours? You press yours. Press that switch. Press that switch. You press yours. You press yours. Yeah. Okay. So that's working. I think it's all. Wait. No, not you guys again. Wait. You. Okay. Fine. You guys check whether yours working? Not working? Not working? Okay, fine. Okay, yeah. Oh. You guys are already in a hurry. Okay, so others are not working now? Fine. You try? Okay, you guys try? Okay, yeah, so... So
the idea was that, I mean, you know, whoever presses the buzzer, it just locks the buzzers in place and no one else can, so we know who pressed the buzzer first. So there are 10 questions. Every question is on a buzzer. There are 30 seconds for each question, and there's negative marking, plus 10, minus 5 points for each question. So those lagging behind can risk it and score some points. Those who are well ahead can also risk it and probably lose some points, or maybe gain much more. So this round is called Question the Answer. So the reason it's called Question the Answer is because I'll give you an answer to a fairly specific question, and you have to tell me what the question is, okay? I'll give you the answer, you tell me what the question is, okay? So is that clear to people here? This round is called Question the Answer. The reason it's called Question the Answer is because I'll give you the answer. You have to tell me what the question is. Okay? So the question will typically be of the form what is, who is, that sort of form. Okay? No, I'll pass it on to the audience. So you just get one shot. So there's no... So if you think you know it, just press the buzzer first, okay? So, yeah. Give an example, as in. Give me an answer. Dr. Livingstone, I presume. That's the answer. Give me the question. It's not in the quiz. Dr. Livingstone, I presume. Dr. Livingstone, I presume. Yeah, I forgot what the question was. this is the journalist guy, right? Yeah, who's? Yeah, what did Stanley say when he met Livingstone? He was searching for the source of the Nile or something, right? No, Livingstone went missing searching for that. So Stanley was a journalist who was looking for him. Anyway, that's history. That's exploration and stuff. So let's. So that will be the generic format of this round, okay? And you can press the buzzer anytime you want to, but I will read out the whole question. And in case you press the buzzer, you're stuck with the question. You're supposed to answer it. If you don't answer it, you earn minus 5, okay? And so be careful when you press the buzzer. You're free to press it before I've read it out, but I mean, yeah. So there's negative marking. So I'll just reset everything once. just to be sure that don't press anything. So now when you press, the thing will be locked. Okay, so can we have the first buzzer question, answer? Nullius in verba, take nobody's word for it. It is an expression of the determination of fellows to withstand the domination of authority and to verify all statements by an appeal to facts determined by experiment. Nobody is pressing the buzzer? Come on, the high scoring teams can risk it. Go ahead. No? None of you guys? Audience. Ranjay. Yeah? Yes. Don't tell me you knew you knew that this was in the quiz. Okay. So what is the motto of the Royal Society? So take nobody's word for it, okay? No, I mean, that's the motto. Okay, so the next answer is a proposed test of a computer's ability to think, requiring that the covert substitution of the computer for one of the participants in a keyboard and screen dialogue should be undetectable by the remaining human participant. Come on, guys. I'll give you a clue. The guy, this, anyway, I mean, a question, a related question has appeared in an earlier, one of the earlier rounds. But anyway, yeah. Let them, there's no point to the buzzer round if you don't press any buzzers. Anybody wants to give it a shot here? It's appeared in one of the previous rounds, so. Anybody wants to try? Huh? No, no, but what is the question? You need to give me a question. No, but close. They get minus five, by the way. So, that's, what is, can we have the question? Oh, I'm sorry, I should have asked the audience. What is the Turing test? So that's what the Turing test is. They get minus five, okay? So that's reset. Okay, so can you have the third answer? But good, good. You guys press the buzzer at least. Answer three. She was a German mathematician who made contributions to abstract algebra. And theoretical physics. Right, so that's correct. Who is Emmy Noether? Who was Emmy Noether? So I'll give it to you. 10 points to Bose. Okay, I did reset it, right? Yeah. Don't press it right now. So that's Emmy Noether. Who was Emmy Noether? Next answer. She was a British biophysicist who specialized in X-ray crystallography. Her X-ray photographs of the DNA molecule helped discover its double helix structure. James Watson, Francis Crick, and Maurice Wilkins received a Nobel Prize for the double helix model of DNA in 1962, 4 years after her death. Give me the question. Come on, someone press the buzzer. Anybody? Hey. No? You guys? Come on. You are way ahead of the rest of them. You can still give it a shot. Doesn't matter. -5 won't hurt you. On the other hand, if you're right, then yeah, you'll cover up. You'll recover your -5. You have a guess? No, you don't even have a guess. Anybody has a guess? No. No. Okay. Question goes to the answer goes to the audience. Give me a question. You want to answer? You want to? Yeah. Huh? No. Give me a question, and it's not related to Marie Curie. Not you. You're mad science. Someone not from mad science. No, I gave you one answer, one question. Who? I gave you one. Is there anyone else wanted to try? Okay, you. Huh? What? No. Give me a question. We're talking about a person here. So the question has to be related to this person. Yeah. Yes, who was Rosalind Franklin?
So she, sorry.
Okay, yeah, I mean, this was too, anyway. So, yes, she didn't get enough credit for her work on the double helix structure of the DNA, and yeah, so that's Rosalind Franklin. So the wait, let me just be sure that I reset these. So the next answer, can we have the next answer? A particle physics research project to primarily study atmospheric neutrinos in a 1200 meter, okay, so Barbara, Team Barbara, go for it. What is the question? Ah, right. Okay. Well, I'll give it to you. So that's Team Baba, 10 points. So you recover your -5. Good. Okay. So that's the first half of this buzzer round. So feel free to press the buzzer. That's what I mean. Okay. So the next answer. A programming language noted for its similarity to pseudocode and named for a popular British comedy troupe. What about the engineering guys? They'd be into programming, right? I mean, the college guys. You should know. I don't know if they teach it in school, but. You guys want to try? Press the buzzer. No? Too excited about others' question, right? No? Nobody's trying? Okay, so the question goes to the audience. Sorry, the answer goes to the audience. Give me a question. Yeah. No, it's not what is Pascal. Wait. Let me. Yeah, you. No, it's not Unix. Who's asking? Yeah, you. Yes. What is Python? Chocolate. Do I have? You, right? Fairly accurate. So what is Python? It's a programming language, right? I mean, I don't know if you guys have heard of it, right? I mean, you should have tried. Anyway, so the next answer. A semiconductor device used to amplify and switch electronic signals and electrical power. It is composed of semiconductor material with Team Baba, with at least 3 terminals for connection to an external circuit. Go ahead.
Transistor.
Huh?
Transistor.
What is the question?
What is a transistor?
Yeah. Okay. So what is a transistor? Team Baba plus 10. So can we have the next answer? An American medical researcher and virologist, he's best known for his discovery and development of the first successful polio vaccine. Yeah. What is the question? Yeah, use the mic.
Who is John Salk?
Yeah. Who is John Salk? So that's Team Raman, plus 10 to them. Good work. Chocolates you'll get later. Okay, so that's we're through. We're left with two more questions in this round. Let's go to the next answer. Sorry, two more answers in this round. Yeah. This natural phenomenon is a brilliant...
Aurora.
What is the question?
Explain the natural phenomenon in Aurora.
Okay, I'll give it to you. What is in Aurora? Yeah, okay. So they get plus 10 for this. This was fairly easy. I mean, you guys didn't know it? You should have tried it. Anyway, so the next answer, the last answer of this round. A thermal radiation filling the universe, its spectrum is... Yeah, go ahead.
This is a cosmic microwave background radiation.
Yes, what is CMBR? Good work. So that is Team Bose. We have a special answer. This is a bonus answer for everybody. It's free for all. Come up with good questions. There's many possible questions. I want an interesting question, a non-trivial question. Okay, so can we have the next answer? Give me a question.
What is sum of 21?
42, really? Okay, we'll vote. No. There's no. That's the thing. Nobody knows what the question is. That's why I'm, polling for good non-trivial questions. Yeah, you guys want to try?
What's the answer to life?
No.
And the universe.
Look, the thing is that then I'll ask you what is the question. I mean, nobody knows what the ultimate question is. So, anybody else?
Okay.
Huh? No.
Here.
Yeah. Huh? Yeah, that's true. It's the maximum score at IN, at the International Mathematical Olympiad. That's the perfect score, 42/42. That's one thing. But I want a nice. Let's say. Oh, there should be plenty of mathematicians here, right? Give me a nice. Let's say a nice mathematical, non-trivial question.
5 mod 2.
Not what is 6 times 7. Anything other than that. Huh? I don't want that. We don't know what that question is, so we'll find out. Huh? Yeah, what is the question?
Name a number with the square of the number in the first decimal place. In the second decimal. Not second decimal, tenth place.
Sorry, you didn't follow. 2 square is 4. So, I mean, that way,
93.
It's the smallest, is it? 93 is another example.
11
is a trivial example. Look, it's not that non-trivial. I mean, there's many more members in the set. Yeah. Huh? Yeah, try, go ahead. I'm confused. What? Sorry. Quiet. Yeah. Is that the only example of the class that you're suggesting? Anyway, Look, I mean, I'm not saying there's one unique question. I'm just looking for interesting questions. That's all. I'm not saying there's one. I mean, look, even what is 6 times 7 is also fair enough, but that's not what I'm looking for. Seven square minus seven and six square plus six. More. Yeah. Okay. Wait. Okay, I'll give away some chocolates. Who said six square plus six? Seven square minus seven? Sorry. Yeah. Anyone else? 2 to the power of 21 is a big number. This is 2 times 21. I'll give you as many as you want. Give me more questions.
Oh, that's your question?
That's not 42.
This answer is loading.
I'm not sure how much that is, but that's not 42. I'm sure. If you have bitcoins, I'll count it actually. I'll be surprised if it's 42. Anyway, so let me just point out a nice fact about 42. What is the only two-digit primary pseudo-perfect number? So a primary pseudo-perfect number is when you take the prime factors of the number, take 1 by the prime factor, sum them up with 1 by the number itself, and you should get 1. So there's very few examples of this class. There's 2, so 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1. There's 6, so 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 is 1. Then there's 42, and after that there's 1806, 47,058. And then it goes out of control. I mean, then it's very difficult to, you know, because I know, but I mean, this is much rarer, is all I'm trying to say. So this is one possible question. I mean, I was just looking around for a nice possible question. So this is one. Let's go ahead with the next round, I think, yeah. Huh? Oh. We're done with the buzz around. Scores, yeah. So can we have the scores? Right, so team Bhava has 90 points. Team Bose has 35 points. Chandra, 20 points. Raman, 10 points. And Saha is yet to open their account. It's already rapid fire time. This is the, okay, where is my question set? I have to search for the question set. So this round has 10 questions per team. Just if you have any doubts about the rules, just ask right now. 60 seconds to answer them. So as many as you can answer within 60 seconds, a maximum of 10 questions. Plus 5 points per correct answer. There's no negative marking. You can answer a question that you passed up earlier if you have any time remaining, like, of those 60 seconds. I'll circle back. Okay? So I have 5 sets of questions for the different 5 different teams. And so I'll need help from some volunteers. So can you volunteer? Yeah. So, somebody needs to be here next, sit here with me. Just to tell me when the answer is right and what. I mean, usually I'd know, but. So which way should we start? The other way? You guys want to start? I'll let you choose. Do you want to start with the first set? Huh? Or do you want them to start? I'll let you choose. Huh? You want them to start? Okay, so we'll have them start. Let me have some water. that is for Team Bhabha. There'll be 10 questions, a maximum of 10. Huh? No, no, they'll not be on the screen, so you have to listen, okay? So, a maximum of 10 questions. Timer, who's the timer? You're the timer, yeah, right? So just let me know when it's 60 seconds. You start and stop, so. Yeah, so whenever you say start, I'll start. Not among, which element am I referring to? In which body or water are the islets of Langerhans found? Who?
Pancreas.
Pancreas, that's correct. Who proposed the structure of benzene in 1865? The remainder when 14 to the power 20 is divided by 13 is 1. True or false? Incorrect. Microsoft is a portmanteau that is a combination of which two words? What is linear caustic?
Sodium hydroxide.
Incorrect. Rapid thief, which extinct creature am I referring to? Who was awarded the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for carbon-14 dating? Stop. You can try this. Who was awarded the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for carbon-14 dating? No, your time is up. You can try this one. No? Okay. So how many did they get right? They got one question right, the second question, which is, in which body of water are the islets of Langerhans found? They're found in the pancreas, and by the body of water, I meant the human body. Okay, so let me just for the audience, these are the answers to the questions. Not alone, which element am I referring to? I'm referring to antimony. Antimonos means not alone. Then who proposed the structure of benzene in 1865? Kekule. You didn't answer that. Why? Come on. It's rapid fire. okay, so the remainder when 14 to the power 20 is divided by 13 is 1. That's true. Microsoft is a portmanteau of microcomputer software. What is lunar caustic? It's silver nitrate. The formula is AgNO3. Rapid thief, which extinct creature am I referring to? It's Velociraptor. Anyway. Who was awarded the Nobel Prize in Chemistry for carbon-14 dating? That's Willard F. Libby. Okay, so these were the questions asked. The next set is for Team Bose. Are you ready? Yeah. Timer. Yeah. So whenever you say start, I'll start. Bauxite is an ore of which metal?
Aluminium.
True. Correct. Yeah. Expand Intel. Which organ is an isotope of oxygen? True or false?
True.
False. Incorrect. Which acid is found in tamarind?
Tartaric.
Correct. Ray Tomlinson may not have created email, but he was the first person to use what everyday symbol? What is aquafortis? Aquafortis. Stars produce energy at their centers by converting hydrogen, their main constituent, into which gas?
Helium.
Correct. What is somnambulism? Somnambulism.
Sleepwalking.
Correct. What is aspirin chemically known as? Which gland secretes oxytocin? Bauxite is okay. Expand Intel.
Intelligent.
No. Okay, so 60 seconds up. How many did they get right? So they got 4 out of 10 right. So that's Team Bose. So the questions were, bauxite is an ore of which metal? Aluminium. Intel expands to integrated electronics. Ozone is an isotope of oxygen. That's false. It's an allotropic form of oxygen. Which acid is found in tamarind? Tartaric acid, that they answered correctly. Ray Tomlinson may not have created email, but he was the first person to use the symbol at the rate of the special character. What is aquafortis? That's nitric acid. Stars produce energy at the centers by converting hydrogen, their main constituent, into helium. Yeah, that was that they answered correctly. Somnambulism is sleepwalking. Aspirin is chemically known as acetyl salicylic acid. And which gland secrete oxytocin? That's the pituitary gland. Okay, so the next set of questions is going to be for Team Chandra, right? You tell me when to start, okay? Yeah. Name the first ever organic compound synthesized in the laboratory. Malachite and azurite are the ores of which important metal? Malachite and azurite are the ores of which important metal?
Iron. Iron.
No. Name the radioactive isotope of carbon used in carbon dating.
Carbon-14.
Correct. Who invented the World Wide Web? Name the organ in the digestive system of birds for grinding and purging. Tim Berners-Lee. That's correct. Just answer that part. Yeah. Name the organ in the digestive system of birds for grinding and pulverizing hard shell grains and seed.
Gizzard.
Yeah. Gizzard. Correct. What is studied by the doctor when he conducts an electromyography?
What
is studied by the doctor when he conducts an electromyography?
Next.
What is the formal name of a lie detector?
Lie detector. Next.
What does the liquid drop model attempt to describe? What does the liquid drop model attempt to describe? You can take this.
Milken's soil drop experiment.
No.
Milken's soil drop experiment.
No, the liquid drop model is. You want to try something else? That's not correct. Anyway.
Repeat the question. Can you repeat the question?
What does the liquid drop model attempt to describe? It's a model for something. What is it trying to model?
To explain separation of atoms.
No, it's the atomic nucleus. Okay, so they got three questions right. So that's good. So the name, the first ever organic compound synthesized in the laboratory, that's urea. Malachite and azurite are the ores of copper. Radioactive isotope of carbon used in carbon dating is C14, which they answered correctly. Who invented the World Wide Web? That's Tim Berners-Lee. The organ in the digestive system of birds for grinding and pulverizing hard shell grains and seed is called gizzard, which they answered correctly. What is studied by the doctor when he conducts an electromyography? Muscles. Formal name of a lie detector is polygraph. What does the liquid drop model attempt to describe? The atomic nucleus. Which brain disorder? Okay, these are questions I did not ask, but anyway, I'll read them out. Which brain disorder leads to progressive, irreversible decline in memory? Anybody in the audience? Alzheimer's, yes, that's correct. Okay, let me find if... what meteor shower is also referred to as the Tears of St. Lawrence? Anybody? What meteor shower is also often referred to as the Tears of St. Lawrence? This is just a fun question. You want to try? No. Anybody? No? Audience? Versailles, yes. So who answered it there? I won't be able to. So somebody please pass it on. Sorry. Yeah, you'll get it for helping me out with the round. Okay. So the next team is Team Raman, right? You guys had your turn. So Team Raman, your turn towards that side. Yes. Yeah. So wait. Let me see. Okay. Yeah. So you tell me when to start. Okay. Yeah. Name the organ that produces urea. No. Which layer of the atmosphere influences the propagation of radio waves?
Ionosphere.
Correct. Name the acid found in ants.
Formic acid.
Correct. Which body organ is lined by the dura mater?
Next.
A magnifying glass is what type of lens?
Convex.
Correct. Two vectors have unequal magnitudes. Can their sum be zero? On an average, women's heart beat faster than men. True or false?
True.
Correct. What term is used to refer to egg-laying animals?
Oviparous.
Correct. What is the name of the built-in safety flap that covers the entrance to the trachea, windpipe?
Epiglottis.
Correct. Expand laser.
Light.
Light amplification, symmetry, emission of laser. Radiation.
Correct. Name the organ that produces urea. You can take it. Oh, but you that was, oh yeah, you can still try it. Yeah, but that's incorrect. You want to change your, because you had time, so you can. No. No? Huh? No, that's the liver. The organ. Okay, so they got 7 out of 10 right. So that's very good. Yeah, that's some redemption. Yeah. So that's so we had 10 questions. Name the organ that produces urea. That's liver. Which layer of the atmosphere influences the propagation of radio waves? That's the ionosphere. Which name the acid found in ants? Formic acid. Or methanoic acid. Which body organ is lined by the dura mater? That's the brain. A magnifying glass is a convex lens. Two vectors of unequal magnitudes, well, their sum cannot be zero. On an average, women's heart beat faster than men. That's apparently true. What term is used to refer to egg-laying animals? Oviparous. What is the name of the... any question? What is the name of the built-in safety flap that covers the entrance to the trachea, windpipe? That's the epiglottis, which they got right. Expand laser. Laser is just light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Okay. So the last set of questions is for team Saha. Right? Name the region of space-time from which gravity prevents anything, including light, from escaping. Identical twins have identical fingerprints. True or false?
False.
If you connect the hydrogen atoms in a methane molecule, what platonic solid do you get? Does water expand or contract on freezing? How many bits make a byte? How many bits make a byte? No. The angles of a triangle on the surface of a sphere sum to pi. True or false? The angles of a triangle on the surface of a sphere sum to pi. True or false?
False.
Correct. When referring to blood groups, what does Rh in Rh factor stand for? What does Rh in Rh factor stand for when referring to blood groups?
pH value.
No, dude. Name the habitable artificial satellite in low Earth orbit visible to the naked eye. Name the iron-containing oxygen transport metalloprotein in the red blood cells of almost all vertebrates. You can take this. Name the iron-containing oxygen transport metalloprotein in the red blood cells of all vertebrates. Almost all. Hemoglobin, that's correct. So, okay, so they answered 9. They got 3 correct. Yeah. So the 10 questions were, name the region of space-time from which gravity prevents anything, including light, from escaping. Anybody in the audience?
Did you get a chocolate before?
I'll give you one more. Yeah, okay, so the next. Identical twins have identical fingerprints. That's false. Yeah. If you connect the hydrogen atoms in a methane molecule, what platonic solid do you get? Anybody wants to try? Not you. Huh?
Not you.
Anyone else who... Okay, I'll give it to you. Anybody else? But I think people heard it. So. Sorry, a little. Yeah. The platonic solid is a tetrahedron. Does water expand or contract on freezing? It expands. How many bits make a byte? That's 8 bits. Why did you say 120? 1024. Anyway, So the angles of a triangle on the surface of a sphere sum to pi, that is false. They'll be greater than sum to greater than pi. When referring to blood groups, what does RH in RH factor stands for? That's when you say a blood group is like O positive, O negative. That positive is the RH factor, I think. So anybody wants to answer this question? What does the RH in RH factor stand for?
Rhesus monkey.
Rhesus? Okay, I'll give it to you. Okay. So, name the habitable artificial satellite in low Earth orbit visible to the naked eye. Audience? ISS, yeah, that's the International Space Station. You can actually, on evenings, some evenings, you can actually see it go across the sky. So NASA has this, if people don't know, NASA has this service where you can subscribe to an automated email every time the ISS is going to pass by your particular part of the world. So I have subscribed to the Chennai update, so I get to know at what time of the day I'll see the ISS, you know, crossing, going across the sky. So it's like a star going across. I think I've seen it from going from southwest to northeast. It's interesting. You should watch it at least once. Name the iron-containing oxygen transport metalloprotein in the red blood cells. That's hemoglobin, which they answered correctly. This question is open to the audience. A well-known American astronomer, he wrote the novel Contact. Identify him. Yeah, everybody knows it. So no chocolates. did you get a chocolate before? You did, okay, anyway. Okay, so we're done, I think. This is the end of the quiz. Can we have the scores, the final scores? Right. So these are the final scores? Okay. So what are the... Okay. So we'll go third, second, and first. Yeah. So, okay. Just mark it. We'll ask the so actually let me just first announce the scores, and we'll also request the director to award the prizes to the students. So sir, if you could come here probably. Yeah, can you just So there's been a bit of a turnaround because of the last two rounds, which was essentially the idea of the last two rounds. So let me just announce the scores. So Team Saha had made 30 points. So the third prize goes to, third prize still goes to Team Bose, right? Oh, they get second. Right. So, sorry. Okay, so Team Raman, they get the second prize. They get the third prize with 45 points. 45 points. Team Raman, 45 points. The second prize goes to Team Bose with 55 points. And the first prize goes to Team Baba with 95 points. So that brings us to the end of the quiz. Thank you everybody for showing up and showing some enthusiasm for the quiz. I'm sorry about the last mess up about the scoring. I hope you guys enjoyed it. So that's it. Thank you. Let me just, yeah. Oh, word of thanks are in order. Firstly, I'd like to thank the administration for making this open day possible. Without their help, it's impossible to organize events at this scale. So especially, I mean, our director, Mr. Vishnu Prasad, and everybody in the office who helped. Then I also have to, since I organized the quiz, I have to thank people who helped me with the quiz. Everybody who helped with the prelims, the checking, the distribution, collection, especially Bhaskar, who actually translated the entire quiz into Tamil last night. At least one person attempted it in Tamil, so that's nice. Then I have to thank Madhusudan, who contributed a lot of questions. He was the one who was running the slideshow. Anand for the timekeeping. Should I thank you guys? You messed up the story. but still, thank you. Archana and so those are the people who messed up, okay? Catch them. Ashna and Sri Lakshmi for scoring. Thank you to the participants. It was fun. I mean, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you, everybody. Yeah. But people with the demos and announcement, there's some snacks outside right now. Kamal wants to say something.
Just to wrap everything up, so we'll just thank everyone who has participated and contributed in today's program. And thanks to the students who have come and participated in the entire day's program with so much enthusiasm. Please come again next year. And thank you all for coming. Snacks are outside. And as I said, buses at 6:30.
And just to tell you that this whole program was organized by the students, PhD students of IMSC. And I'd really like to thank all the students of IMSC for joining in and contributing to this effort.